Hey guys, I'm Captain Zero, and today I bring you my TM preparation guide for TM Weevil, which is the TM happening in global for the in the next 2 days. In 2 days we have him here. He's a very good character. He's a very good character, and in global we are going to have our second exclusive invasion, which is going to be pretty amazing, guys. So let's get right into it. As always, we're going to talk about the TM, the general information of the TM. We're going to talk about Weevil, the different bosses. I'm going to comment the free-to-play teams, my teams, and how to play the teams. Any information? It's the second TM that Global is going to give us an exclusive invasion to have the beard mechanic again. That is very good. I hope that Lau is as easy as Señor Pink was, honestly. Señor Pink was very easy. Let's see what Lau happens, because Lau doesn't have a right version. Making the teams, this TM is not that great for free to play, because there's a few mechanics that are missing. Silence, despair, removals. In one of my teams, I had to put a non-boosted unit, so yeah. It's bad, but it's the only way I saw to do it. For this TM, as always, with no secret map, 7 million rewards, on sub 500 new world, you will get reds with recent legends. The Cavendish and the Flamingo schools will be available on the blue ticket shop, and Smooven will also be available, which is a very good unit, guys. If you don't have a Smooven, please grab it, because Smooven is amazing, guys. It's top 2 unit, top 1 or 2 unit with this guy right here. And I'm putting a disclaimer. On the last TM, there were a few fights with retooled mechanics, different mechanics, and also the last TM, the fights didn't scale at all. If you fight the enemies on the gauntlet, they didn't have more stats. So, my guide is focused to the information of the Japanese TM, the TM on the Japanese version, but it may change a bit, just a bit. It should be right almost 90% of the time, 99%. Okay, so let's talk about Weevil. His captain ability, he boosts the attack of a slasher characters proportionally to the crew current HP by 325 at max and their HP by 135. Okay. He's a decent captain. Going by max HP is not that crazy, but maybe a nice captain for free-to-play players. His special ability is where the juice is at, guys. The special ability reduces attack down duration by 20 turns, adds 300 times his attack as additional times damage to one own attacks for 2 turns. If the enemies have all the buff protection or the light debuff protection, at the time when the special is activated, boost the attack of all characters by 2 times. Where do I start, guys? These 3 effects are amazing. Only 2 of these effects will be a good TM unit, but he has 3 of the 3 effects at the same time, and he's an amazing unit. He removes 20 turns of attack down. He's the highest attack down remover. If you don't have Brindy Wall, he's the best attack down remover, and he's free to play. So yeah, the only guy that does more than him is Limited Rare Recruit Brindy Wall. I don't know if there's a unit in Japan that does more. I think not. So for now, we have a character that reduces 20 turns of attack down. That's amazing. He adds 300 characters of attack, his attack 300 times as additional types of damage to his attacks, only him, for 2 turns. This is also good because it's only to him, but it's 300 times. So it's kinda like a Sabo special concentrated in one unit, which is good. It can be good. It can have its uses. It can increase damage a bit, which is very good still. And the last part, if the enemy has all debuff protection or the light debuff protection, you boost the attack of everyone by 2 times for 1 turn. That's amazing, guys. Universal attack booster with a condition. Yeah, but universal attack booster. 2 times attack booster. This guy is above Red Rayleigh, for example. It's amazing, guys. Like, all 3 effects are great by themselves, but the 3 together are just so good. Also, if you think about it, this guy combines with TM Whitebear, because TM Whitebear, with the same condition, boosts your orbs, which is pretty funny, I have to say. My review on this guy is top 1 or 2 with Smooth, and if you start playing a new account, I'm almost telling you to get this guy, Smooven and Big Mom at the most, I would say. But I would pick this guy and Smooven first. The 3 effects are incredible, and having 3 on the same special is so great. He's a, I wanted to give him the same score as Smooven, but I think it would be a bit unfair. So I decided to drop him at 9.5. Still, him and Smooven are the top 2 units on TM, in my opinion. You should get both of them, if possible. As a Sailor, he boosts the HP and attack of everyone by 50, which is amazing. His support ability for Slasher characters, and his Slasher character, he adds 120 times his damage in tap timing to Slashers in the last battle. Still, so it's like his special, a mini version of his special. Again, amazing. It's completely amazing. And yeah, he's very useful for a lot of things. He's a very good attack down remover, the best, basically. His attack boost is universal, so he's also very good in that regard. You can use him in a lot of situations, and he's not going to disappoint you guys. So yeah, this guy, don't sleep on him. He's top 1 or 2, I say it again, top 1 or 2 unit of TM with Smooven. Let's talk about the bosses. Oh, wow, this is very empty, right, you say? Buggy, he has very bad HP, normal attack, you can see 100k HP. His preemptive action puts a 5 perfect hits barrier for 50 turns. That's it. He doesn't do anything else. He doesn't increase his, he doesn't have any trigger, HP, death, anything. You just boomer him down and bam, he's dead. That's why my important free to play units for him is basically just Jack, because Jack is going to destroy him. On the map, always. And on the gauntlet until a certain point, which is why I will focus the team to killing him with other specials and Jack. Yeah, this is a very easy fight, guys. Definitely the last in priority. Don't ever fight this guy on the map unless you don't have Jack. Next one is Kuma. He has this HP attack. His preemptive action, he puts resilience for 3 turns, poison and toxic immunity for 99 turns. If you manipulate your orbs, he blinds you for 3 turns, and he makes color orbs badly matching for 6 turns. All color orbs, the 5 color orbs. And his 20% trigger heals to 30% HP. As you can see, the most annoying part of this fight is the resilience and the color orbs badly matching. So that's why I'm including Bartok, which is the only free-to-play resilience remover. There's other ways to kill him, like using a Smooven, for example. But I'm not going to go into them. And obviously units that make your orbs matching so he can apply his debuff, which is, are basically Smoothie and Kolokata. There's also Blenheim, I think, but Blenheim is absolute crap. I'm not, probably not a lot of people have him. But yeah, it's a decent difficulty fight, but if you have the right units, you should be able to take it down. Next one is Boa. Oh, guys, this fight is making my head hurt. I had so many problems thinking a team for this fight. She has 640 HP, KHP, 4k attack, preemptive action, she clears all your boobs, shuffles your orbs, 99 turns of immunity, blinds you for 7 turns, paralyzes everyone for 4 turns, and silences 3 random units for 3 turns. And if that isn't enough, guys, she, if you boost your attack, she reduces your attack to 0.2 times for 10 turns. And 20% trigger, she binds everyone for 20 turns. This fight is absolutely annoying. And you know what's the most annoying point of this fight? The 3 Sailor bind. The 3 Sailor bind. The 3 random, not Sailor, sorry. The 3 random unit bind. Can be your captain, can be your Sailors, can be anyone. This sucks, guys, because it's so random and there is no free-to-play unit that can remove silence and being immune to silence. There is no boosted unit that can do that. That's why I'm very sorry, but my free-to-play team, I took the approach of using Robin and Enel to remove the bullshit and then just kill him. Kill her. She's, even if you fight her on the map, she's still pretty annoying because you have to stall 4 turns at least. So I think it's better to just use Robin and Enel and kill her as fast as possible and just don't worry about her points. The last time, the last map fight, we have Mihawk with a good HP, decent attack. As a preemptive action, he puts immunity for 99 turns. He has, he puts a 9 turn chain coefficient down to 0.1 times, and he puts a barrier, a one hit barrier, for 9 turns. And the turn 1, he will put an end of turn damage buff on him for 0.5 times his attack. And when you kill him, he will revive to full, change to int type, deal 1.2 his attack in int damage, and he will run away. I'm like, what? Okay. If you haven't realized it, this fight is made so you use Call of Rook. This fight tries to justify Call of Rook usage, but Call of Rook sucks so much that I just don't even use him here. I just use him on my main team because I want to get more points. Here, with just Niwatori, you can do the same and you don't have any problem. And the other important unit is basically a strange captain. I use Ace on the free-to-play team. And Boa is very good because she's Chain Locker. I don't think there's another free-to-play Chain Locker, I think. So she's amazing for this fight because she will increase your damage and negate the chain coefficient down. Okay, let's get with Weevil. Weevil, this is a stage 6 stats. He will have 500k HP, 3.6k attack. Preemptive action, attack down for 4 turns. He seals your strength, dex and quick character specials for 5 turns. And if you left him at 50% HP, he will blow away 2 random siders for 3 turns. As you can see, this fight is dangerous. You should not bring him to 50% HP. And you should not bring strength, dex and quick unit specials if you are going to use them. If you need them, they are not good enough because they are going to be silenced and means you will have to stall up to 2 or 3 turns, depending on what you are going to do on the next fight, just to remove the special seal. And the attack down is annoying, but we have a few ways to deal about that. Basically, the stars for this fight are Rory, are Nami, Christmas Nami, because she will remove 3 turns of the attack down. And when you get him, Weevil is the best for this fight because he will remove it also and increase your damage, damage with the tap timing bonus, so he will be very good for killing him. So Weevil and Nami are the most important units for the stage 6. For stage 7, he has 1.1 million HP, 4.5 attack. The preemptive action dispers captains for 6 turns, 99 turns of immunity, changes all orbs to G, bomb and tandem, 4 turns of threshold barrier and one of the effects below, which is 25 hit barrier for 1 turn, or 4 perfect hit barriers for 1 turn, or 3 PSI orb barrier for 1 turn. On the first turn, he will double your damage taken for 10 turns. If you left him at 50% HP, he will enrage for 1.5 his attack and 30% damage reduction for 2 turns. I think the enrage is permanent. At 20% HP, he will blow away 4 characters randomly. Okay, as you can see, this fight is annoying. This fight, basically, the unit that destroys it, it's the new Marco, the TM booster Marco, because he removes the despair and the threshold barrier, and also it can give you orbs if you use another unit that removes the G and bomb orbs. So, and tandem. So, if you don't have a Marco friend, you're going to have way less points than other, because you have to use a few units that don't have 1.35. If you have a Marco friend, you can go all out. Basically, if you don't have Marco, you are going to have to use both Kuma to remove the threshold and Hiruluk to remove Despair. And yeah, the invasion boss, as always, is the last time. Not going to talk about him because we don't know anything about him. It can be whatever. It can be strong, it can be weak. We don't know. Guys, when we know what happens with him, I will update the guide. I will release another video and update the picture guide. So yeah, these are my free-to-play teams. I'm not going to go too deep into explaining them. Just saying that the order is more or less the same. Boa, Mihawk, Kuma, Boogie. Boa is annoying as hell. I'm not going to go deep because you have the explanation on the end. These are my teams. I'm going to explain that there's two teams for Weevil because one is if you don't have Marco Frien, and the other one is if you have Marco Frien, basically. So yeah, the playthrough is here, you can pause it here or you can watch the picture guide, which is the same, basically. If you have any doubts, guys, please drop them in the comments and I will try to solve them as much as possible. If you see any error in my teams, like last time I tried to use General Frankie on a team that had Frankie already, on a team that had Zoro already, just tell me in the comments and I will fix them as soon as possible. Yeah, guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked this guide. I hope you can make your teams with my help. And yeah, I hope you have a good treasure hunting. And I hope to see you on the next video of my stream. See you.